Well, the South Australian Premier is defending his decision to bring the controversial LIV Golf Series, sponsored by the Saudi government, to Adelaide for 4 years.
And Peter Malinauskas joins us now. Very good morning, Premier.
Morning, Ali. Morning, Carl.
Morning.
So, look, you know, depending on who you talk to here, this is either a huge coup or you've done a deal with the human rights devil. Which one is it?
Well, we think it's a coup for South Australia. I mean, the simple fact is we haven't seen high-calibre golf in our country for a very long time. And I haven't seen the USPGA or anyone else do from the golfing world do Australia favours. And I'm conscious of the fact that there are, you know, those who are in the more establishment camp of golf who are proffering arguments that I think have a high degree of hypocrisy and inconsistency within them. But, look, my firm focus is backing up our tourism industry in South Australia.
So how much did that weigh into it? Because I do personally think it's fantastic for golf and the sport here in this country. But there are these other human rights elements of it. How much did that weigh into it?
Oh, look, Carl, of course we factored that in and I thought about it a fair bit before starting to go through the bid process with LIV Golf. But the simple fact is this. I mean, Saudi Arabia is an open trading partner of Australia to a very large degree. More than that, we've actually got a defence relationship with Saudi Arabia. As far as the South Australian export market is concerned, they're a top 20 export market. I mean, Bali alone, we send them well over $300 million worth just from our state every single year. So at a federal government level, there's been a conscious decision made to engage with Saudi Arabia. If you take the argument that they shouldn't be engaged with, then you better not be using Facebook anymore or driving an Uber or in a Boeing aircraft or using Pfizer drugs, because all of those things are invested by the Public Investment Fund. But all that being said, my government's relationship is exclusive with LIV Golf, and the only thing that we've got a commercial engagement with is actually hosting the tournament here. So as far as the South Australian taxpayer is concerned, we're just funding hosting a golf tournament, which is going to attract people all over the world to our state.
Yeah, the Premier's just asked you to give up a lot of your favourite things.
And look, it's a very good point that you raised, because then you've got to look at, OK, do you support the World Cup going to Qatar and, you know, there's
Ubers,
there's
Pfizer. Ubers. How are you going to get that Pfizer stuff out of your veins?
See, that is a very good question.
I think, look, my view is the arguments against all this are coming from the USPGA, who are a monopolist force that are trying to keep golf to their establishment rather than sharing it in a different format with younger people across the world, including here in Australia, where we've been deprived for so long. So we're making Adelaide a destination, AFL Magic Round, all rounds in one weekend in mid-April, and then the next weekend we've got this world-class, world elite golf tournament.
I'm with you on the USPGA. They're a disgrace. And the hypocrisy from them is just disgusting. And they've done nothing for golf in this country. So I'm with you on that particular part of it. What's going on in Adelaide? The only thing is Tony Jones in Melbourne reckons you haven't been able to attract any really kind of big things for a while because you lost the Grand Prix. Little dig from TJ.
It was a low blow.
Look, TJ's welcome to have a crack about the past, but we're focused on the future. Look, I mean, TJ, I reckon, would absolutely love being here. All nine games of footy right here in Adelaide the weekend before. It's going to be bigger than Ben-Hur. And, look, we've got a lot to showcase, and all of our research shows that if you come here once, you thoroughly enjoy it, you want to come back a second time. So we see this as an opportunity to get a new demographic to experience our state for the first time.
Do you know what he does? Just don't let him in.
No, absolutely. Like, don't tell him to arrive before the magic round,
right? Or just lock him up with the South Australian cops for a couple of weeks.
Cops and tops.
Yeah, indeed. That's the other option.
Thanks, Premier. Good on you. Appreciate it.
Hey, before you go, TJ, I wanted your thoughts on the controversial LIV Golf Series. It's obviously sponsored by the Saudi government and it's going to Adelaide for 4 years.
Yeah, well, good on Adelaide. I mean, you know, you sort of you take anything you get, wouldn't you? I mean, when you've lost the Grand Prix and other, you know, terrific events.
Oh.
So, look, whether it be a human rights issue, I know that there'd be people saying, look, we don't want a bar of this, and it's it's effectively a rebel tour, et cetera, et cetera. Look, if we're going to go down that path, then you need to look at the World Cup soccer in Qatar, sporting events in China. So I get the whole human rights issue, but what I couldn't get my head around yesterday was Greg Norman. He had the violins out, and I love Greg Norman. He's a great ambassador, and he's sort of, for the some part, been treated pretty poorly by this country with the tall poppy syndrome. But when he got up there yesterday in Adelaide and spoke about how hard it is for the golfers, they're away from their families and they're on the tour and they got the pressures, and you guys in the media, you wouldn't understand that. Well, Greg, if you're going to give $140 million to the likes of Cam Smith for a signing on fee, I reckon they're okay. So put the violin away and just get on with the golf, I'd say.